Next up, we're going to go over to Naomi. And Naomi, where are you coming from today?
Hello, I'm from Pennsylvania.
Pennsylvania! Nice, Naomi from Pennsylvania. Are you like a Voltron fan, Adventure Time fan? Or are you just like someone who's like, I just heard of CoStar.
I'll say I'm probably a little bit of Incredible Crew because I remember watching it when I was little, but I was really young. And then it was Adventure Time, and then my crazy self watching Voltron. sorry, I'm nervous. And then my crazy fan girl self watching Voltron and making like 4,000 fan accounts.
You're making all of the fan accounts. So if I see a fan account on Instagram or Twitter, should I just assume that it's you if I don't know who it is? Because odds maybe. Are probably yeah, maybe if you got like 4,000. You have an army of fan accounts out.
Naomi, what was your question for Jeremy?
Oh yeah. So I do acting, so I was wondering, do you have any advice for people who are starting out with acting?
Ooh, good question. I think my advice is, at least for me, when I started out, I think the best thing is to be as natural as possible. I mean, there'll be roles occasionally and things that call for being different than yourself. The character is something more specific, but I think the best thing to do with acting is to kind of take yourself and put yourself into the situation of whatever it is you're acting out. Because I think that's a good way to kind of have a more natural, genuine read. And a lot of, especially I think you find this more so now, a lot of times it's better to be a little bit more unique and kind of have something that's a little bit different. And so it's, yeah, just, you want to be yourself. And when you're doing that too, you're probably having more fun with it. As far as like getting started, I think it's always just good to be comfortable. So you want to get comfortable in the sense that you want to be used to doing scenes, reading off other people, getting used to a big thing that people have a hard time with at first is if you're like acting out a scene with someone. And this isn't for voiceover, this is for on camera, but I guess it kind of translates a little bit. A lot of times when someone's done with their line and they're not the one actually speaking, they'll just kind of tune out and just be like, you're like no expression in that part of the scene. And they won't realize that, you know, even when you're not saying a line or something, you still, your reactions, you kind of, you stay in the scene. You know, you want to make sure your reaction is still matching what's happening, even if you're not saying anything. And it sounds trivial, but honestly, it's so funny when you watch people who first start acting, because it's so many people do this. I mean, I probably did it as well, to be honest, when I first started out. I think that's, you just kind of get ready for your line, you say your line, and you stop. But it's the real part of it is like just being in the scene, and you want to carry it through the whole way. And so getting comfortable with it, with whether it be like doing like theater stuff, or there's usually like local agencies for like local commercial type stuff, or like student films or like whatever else, if you can gain just experience, that's always the best way. Cause then you have that comfortability, because then when you get the opportunity to do something a little bit higher up, you're going to, look like someone who's already been doing it and they know what they're doing and they're a seasoned pro. So that would be my advice.
Okay. Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome, Naomi.